My name's Mark Todi, and alongside is Kirk Mooney. And Kirk, on behalf of hundreds of volunteers and some very special children, we'd like to welcome everybody to Night of Superstars at the Centene Center in Farmington.
I can't believe it's finally here. I'm so excited, Mark, about this evening. When the kids arrive, well, you know what? It's just going to be a night that we're all going to remember. Let's go have some fun.
Jerry Overberg is alongside. He and his wife have helped to organize this. And, Jerry, it looks like months of hard work are about to pay off.
Well, you'd be surprised. It was less than 2 months. But we've had a lot of fun doing it. Makes you feel good to help other people. And it seems like this is one of those win-win situations where everybody feels good about everything.
Well, it's about to start here in another half an hour or so. But if things come together exactly how you'd hope they would?
I think it'll go beyond our expectation, but I've been involved with the founder of this since, let's see, September. Me and Rhonda met him, and plus Jason Ashley, the recording artist from Nashville. And we just, they touched our hearts, and we said, let's go.
How are the kids? Nervous, excited, a little bit of both?
Crazy. They are so way beyond my expectations from the first time we met them at the dressery, you know, the dress shop, getting their dresses and the tuxedos for the boys. And then we got to see them again today at the Drury Inn. They're staying at the Drury Inn tonight. They've got great clips, had their hair. They were doing the mousse on the hair, the styling of the hair. They had makeup people and from all over the place doing just making them feel like kings and queens, you know.
So many people to say thank you to.
Oh, yeah, too many. It's an army.
Well, congratulations on a job well done.
Thank you, brother.
State Senator Kevin Engler also alongside, and you are one of the presenters today, and it's nice to be able to put down the gavel and get away from Jefferson City and do something like this, isn't it?
Yeah, unfortunately, somebody just told me I look like a big penguin, but it's a great event. We're happy to be here and honored. It's almost politics because we got the presiding commissioner, I see, of Jefferson County here, and Ron Casey, one of the state reps. So we've got part politics here, but it's a great cause, and I understand that the participants are really excited. A lot of the girls, when they were fitting the dress, Kurt Mooney told me that they were very excited about having the and getting the formal wear, and I'm excited about being here.
Ken Waller, also alongside County Executive for Jefferson County. What an event, huh?
Oh, this is awesome. I mean, I'm just glad to be a part of this tonight.
So what do you feel about being a presenter here?
Honored, humbled. I mean, as a public servant, you try to do what you can. You know, you go a lot of different events, but this is the one where people are really making a difference. And I'm very thankful to the Overbergs for taking the bull by the horns and just making this a great event. And we'd like to get this up in Jefferson County in the next couple of years. It'd be really nice.
Well, you know, this is being held at the Centene Center in Farmington, but there's no doubt a Jefferson County influence. And as a county executive, when you point out the positives of being from Jefferson County, it's an event like this you can point to.
Well, yeah, and I think this is where the actual people give back to the community, you know, where the public officials like myself and other ones give back to the community. So I think those are the types of things that you want to have happen in your county and be known for. But I know the Overbergs have done a great job, and I know they're going to have Jason Ashley, you know, he's going to be singing tonight and being a performer. So it's a really good time, and I'm really excited about being one of the presenters and just having a great time and having these kids come and walk on this red carpet. It's going to be a thing. It's going to be a thrill of a lifetime for them.
We'll be right back. Also alongside is Greg Johnson, the founder nationally of Night of Superstars. And Greg, what a wonderful event.
Thanks so much. I'm amazed at just how many people are here. It's just incredible. The kids were amazing. The limos, everybody who has participated in setting this up and getting this going is just awesome. Awesome. And, of course, Jerry and Rhonda Overberg just blew this out. And, of course, the entire advisory board that they put together is just amazing.
How, as the founder of this event, did you get the idea for Night of Superstars?
Well, I'll go through this again, but in a nutshell, I was headed out to an event Saturday morning. Charity event for kids, kind of a ranch day for them, for disabled kids and terminally ill children. I was sitting at a stoplight on my way out there. Again, it was 10 o'clock in the morning. I was sitting right next to a restaurant, and this stretch limo pulls up. I'm thinking 10 o'clock in the morning on Saturday, some drama's about to roll out of this limo, so I kept my eye on it. And back door swings open. Actually, it's two little girls about ages 7 and 10 in pretty little dresses just about to jump out. And they looked back in the limo, and they looked at each other, and their eyes were, like, I mean, just huge. Of course, they were so excited. That exchange went on a few times. Finally, their dad had to come and pull them out of the limo. And I was, you know, the minute and a half that I was sitting there at the light, I was thinking, you know, it must be amazing for these girls, you know, because, you know, they have that type of experience. And, you know, when we're kids, every one of us at some time or another has, you know, we've dreamed about being a superstar or a celebrity of some sort. And it's not because of the money that's attached. It's because of the love and the arms wrapped around you. Then I started thinking about the kids I was going out there to work with. And I thought, you know, how devastating is that? You know, that a lot of these kids really are kind of robbed of those dreams because they realize that they're different and they don't think that they're going to be able to achieve that type of status. You know, a little boy with spina bifida is not going to sit there and go, oh, I'm going to be a quarterback for the Rams, you know. It's just not going to happen. A girl who's a burn survivor is not going to sit there and go, I'm going to be an actress or a model, you know. And the saddest part of all that is they don't realize that they're already superstars because they go through more adversity in 10 minutes of their day, all day long, really, but more in the 10 minutes than we go in, you know, 2 weeks, a month. And yet they overcome, they champion through, they overcome so many adversities, excelling in areas such as academics, athletics, music, community service. They do more than what a lot of us who have all our capabilities are doing. And so, you know, society, I think, has failed in that sense because we haven't really recognized the true superstars and our true heroes. So, and of course, when I started thinking about that, I was going, okay, God, you put this big idea in my head. What do we do? Well, biggest night in Hollywood, you know, everybody thinks of Hollywood. They think celebrity. Biggest night in Hollywood, of course, is Oscars. So I thought, well, let's do a red carpet event and make them the honored celebrities since they deserve to be.
Now, did you expect
that in a nutshell?
It was a big nutshell, but it was a nutshell nonetheless.
You asked.
Did you expect this to blossom into what it's become?
Absolutely not. I was doing it as a hobby back in Dallas. I've been doing this. This is our sixth year. And I was doing it as a hobby, and it just grew so big so quickly. I thought, you know what, we need to do this in every city. And my goals were to, you know, my map was Dallas, Fort Worth, Houston, L.A., New York. And nothing personal, I never thought Farmington, Missouri, or Festus. And Jerry and Rhonda Overberg, they had called me and said, we heard about this event. We would like to host one here. I said, when do you want to do it? They say, February. I go, February 2013 or 2 months? They said, 2 months? I thought, well, you better fly me up there quick and we'll see how it goes. And Jerry and Rhonda have done and their crew have done within, you know, under 2 months. It's amazing. So,
well, congratulations on all your successes.
Well, we certainly appreciate you guys coming out here and thank you very much.
Thank you. Now the MC for tonight's activities joins us now, Monica Adams. And Monica, it's great to see you again.
Hey, it's like 18 or 19 years. I cannot believe this looks amazing tonight. I'm so proud to be back here.
Well, speaking of looking amazing, Monica looks amazing. She hasn't aged a bit since she used to work for us back in the mid-90s?
93. Yeah.
Well, tell us how you got to be a part of Night of Superstars.
You know, ironically, two of the women that put this on tonight, I personal train. And so that's how it all came about. And they said, we would really love for you to be a part of this. And as soon as they told me about these extraordinary children, I was right on board. You know this. We get into this business because we've got the power of the camera, the power of the microphone, and you want to give back. Mm-hmm. This is how you give back and you continue to pay forward. This night, you know it. We're going to have so many emotions going on and just constant chills.
Anytime you can make a kid feel good, it's worth it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I've been reading the bios and the stories of these children and, you know, everything, all the adversity that they overcome and the way they touch lives and the way they pay it forward and all the volunteerism that they do with the different hospitals and organizations, that's what it's all about.
And Monica, for folks who may not be aware, the few that may not be aware, where are you at today?
I work with Fox 2 in the morning doing traffic, and then I do a health and fitness radio show on KMOX in St. Louis. And then I just started a new venture about 4 months ago with Red Fitness Lounge in Clayton.
Congratulations on all your success. It's great to see you.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Monica Adams joining us, as well as the red carpet treatment is well underway at Night of Superstars at the Centene Center in Farmington. Kirk Mooney alongside our station manager at KJF Radio. And Kirk, our radio station's proud to be a part of such a wonderful night, a Night of Superstars.
We are really proud to be a part of this. Ron and Jerry Overberg approached the radio station and myself back in December. And in 2 months' time, we put this whole thing together. And through your help on the airwaves, all the folks at the radio station, we put so many ads, so many promos, so much things on the air to get people involved. And as you can tell, the sponsors came. We're on board. Ron and Jerry are on board. Remax is on board. We're ready for tonight. Are you ready for this?
I'm more than ready for this, because tonight the kids are the superstars.
They are. We're going to have over 20 kids walk the red carpet, some of which have never seen a red carpet, have never wore the attire they're in tonight, and have never been in a limo that they're being escorted to tonight, and then treat it like superstars. And they're all going to get their own little trophies after we talk about their great story about their life inside the auditorium. We'll be right back.
Philip. So that's awesome.